the one and only Lorna
Thank you. grateful to Billy Stritch for writing that beautiful calling, our calling, for playing it so sexually. And nobody really knows, I don't think, what you've been through. I know what you've been through. Every minute. And you're really a champ.
Thank you.
I'll tell you one thing and then I'll get the hell off. I know that we have different fathers, but we have the same mother.
Yep.
And she's looking down right now at you and applauding her asshole.
For the action. The remarkable Dr. Philomena McAndrew. Foundation. Thank you, Philomena, and thank you, Phyllis, for everything. Thank you. These two remarkable, remarkable organizations have led so many women down the road to life while we're fighting for our lives with breast cancer. And now, it is my honor to introduce a lady who has known me almost all my life. Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Miss Phyllis Newman.
What do you see? What are you seeing tonight? You're seeing a gorgeous, talented woman. Has gone through hell with her gorgeous, talented sister. And how are they dealing with it? They're making you laugh, they're entertaining you, and they're having you give their money to these two wonderful organizations. Lorna, thank you so much. This is the 18th year of Nothing Like a Dame, which is pretty extraordinary. For 18 years we've been doing this thing, and the proceeds from tonight's tonight's completely sold out event. We'll benefit the two organizations that Lorna just said. the Dr. Philomena McAndrew Fund of Tower Cancer Research Foundation. That's a mouthful. At last, Dr. Philomena, she's here. Come take a bow. And the Phyllis and Paul Newman Women's Health Initiative of the Actors Fund. Did I make a mistake? I am thrilled to announce that Lorna's Pink Party has raised over $100,000. Tower Cancer Research Foundation provides grants for clinical trials, research, patient support, education, mind holding, to promote more effective treatments for cancer and blood disorders. The Phyllis and Paul Newman Women's Health Initiative of the Actors Fund was established to provide, this lady can't read a card, was established to provide a safety net, and this is the truth, it's a safety net for women in the entertainment community who are coping with critical health problems. And sometimes people think that the Actors Fund is just for actors, but it isn't. It's for writers, costume designers, film editors, ushers, agents, circus clowns. What's the difference? By being here tonight, you are supporting the vital work of both of these organizations. Thank you for being a part of our family. And I do encourage you to visit the websites of both of these organizations and you'll learn a lot. But enough of this. Let's go on with this terrific show for Lorna and everybody. Thank you, sweetheart.
Thank you, Phyllis. And thank you, Philomena. Thank you. I promised I wouldn't cry tonight, but Philomena McAndrew saved my life. Thank you. Doing what you have done for countless women. I stand here tonight so proud and so honored to be here for these two extraordinary organizations. Now, as Phyllis said, let's get on with the show. This next guest of mine, well, when I heard her sing, my jaw hit the floor. And then I went backstage and I met the most beautiful, the sweetest, the kindest woman I have ever met. And I said to her, I said, and this is true, I said, I gotta get this straight. You sing this well, and you're that pretty, and you're this nice, I have three words to say to you. I hate you. Well, friendship. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the remarkable Miss Kelly King.
Well, it's just as humbling the second week. I thought maybe I'd get a little used to it and not so nervous after one of my idols, just as on, two of my idols were just on stage. So I'm here tonight for both of my grandmothers who lost the battle to breast cancer, and also for my aunt who won the battle for breast cancer.
Never give up, never want.
Okay, my next friend is not only an amazing talent, but he is family to my family. He is there for all of us. Whenever we ask him
beautiful.
To be there for
us, beautiful.
He is there. He is, I can't tell you how much I love him. He is our Cartier necklace under the Christmas tree. Ladies and gentlemen, the best, Mr. Jim Caruso.
Putting me on after Kelly King. I don't have whistle tones. You're not going to hear any of that. Horrifying. Next, they'll tell me I'm up here with Nick Adams and Stokes Mitchell or something terrible like that. And then, what? Oh, okay. Welcome. I'm so happy you all are here. It's true that Lorna and Liza are absolute family to me, and my friend Billy Stritch, who's sitting right there. Everyone we all met. Well, 23 years ago. Yeah, I've known Billy 38 years, something. Anyway, when Lorna asked me to do this, I was thrilled, of course. She asked me to do a song called Think Pink, which has lyrics like, oh, my dear's pink brassieres. And I thought, you know, I don't know if this is right for me. Because I am manly. Don't go by the blazer. So, that song was performed by a lady named Kate Thompson, who we knew very well.
Oh, yeah.
Who was Liza's godmother, and of course, the wonderful part of the Liza Lorna family. She was a great friend of ours. And so she gave me this arrangement, Kate did, and so we've been doing it all over the place ever since, and we're going to do it tonight. I'm so thrilled to do this for you with my friends William Blake and Trevor McQueen.
We're ready.
I should have warmed up.
All right. Hold on. I'm going to hear me. Everyone, hear the guys.
Okay. Go for it.
One.
Oh, my mom.
Two, three,
How much do I love you? I'll tell you no lie. How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? How many times a day do I think of you? Oh, no. How many roses are sprinkled with you? How far would I travel? Where you are, how far is the journey from here to the star? And if I ever lost you, how much would I cry? How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? Deep, deep, deep is a deep sea. However deep is a deep sea. Deep sea, oh my goodness, how deep is a deep sea? Oh my goodness, how deep. Right up there, on the reach of heaven. How high can it be? On a piece of major and rod.
Beyond words, all of these words add up to three words. Anne Hampton.
Last week was as well. It is my great honor to say to all of you, which is a sentence I have only said in this room last week and tonight, I am a survivor! And let me tell you, it is wonderful to be alive. When I found out that I had breast cancer, I wrote to my friend Sylvia McNair and I said, Sylvia, she had been through this, and I said, Sylvia, is it going to change my singing? Is it going to change my voice? She said, it's not going to change your voice, but it is going to change your singing. She said, you are going to sing like you've never sung before because you're going to be so happy to be alive. And that's what I'm celebrating.
People
first be a person who needs people.
Describing Nick Adams.
Hi, thank you. I'm so honored to be here tonight with all these ridiculously incredible singers, and as a friend of Lorna's and Colin, but also from my grandmother.
They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're on this date with me, the pickings have been lush, and yet before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners, you might refuse to stay. And so the best that I can do is pray. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck
friend of mine. She is one of the most talented and beautiful friends anyone could ask for. She lights up a room with her being. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear friend, Miss Julie Garnier.
Today to sing for three very special women in my life. The first one was my mother's best friend, and she lost her battle to breast cancer 14 years ago. The second one is a beautiful friend named Doreen, who is fighting every single day with bone cancer, and she is prevailing. She is so strong and amazing to me, I can't even believe it. The third and final one, I'm going to try not to cry, is the woman who helped raise me, my Aunt Elizabeth. And she is really struggling right now, and she's in the final stages, and I love her so much, and she is the main reason that I'm here today. My mother told me the
my next friend, I have known since I was 11 years old. She replaced my sister in Best Foot Forward. And then she went on to capture all of our hearts as the down-to-earth and always wise Julie Cotter in the hit television show Welcome Back, Cotter. She also shrunk her kids. Then she went on to blow up her kids as the eponymous Honey in Honey, I Shrunk and Blew Up the Kids. And I want to tell you a story about her that is very true and so her. She called me 7 years ago and she said, "Well, I've had a really interesting day." I said, "Yeah, what happened?" She said, "I was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer and it's in my bones." And when she heard my reaction, this is exactly what she said to me. She said, "Don't be ridiculous. This thing isn't gonna get me. I'm a fucking cockroach." And it didn't. And she is still fighting and she is with me tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear friend, Miss Marcia Strassman.
She gave me the pity card. It's a very powerful card to have.
Yes, it is.
If I forget the lyrics, which I'm prone to do, even though we have done this song before, then I get the pass.
Yes, you do.
You'll be mouthing the words to me.
I will.
It's okay.
You know, you look fabulous, and
thank
there is
so
only
much.
One perfect song for us.
Oh, yes,
yes.
Right?
We'll always be somebody's friends, sisters, and pals. We'll always be bosom buddies. If life should reject you, there's me to protect you. If I say that your tongue is vicious, if I call you uncouth, my frank observation, my scald.
You think?
I've been meaning to tell you for years, you should keep your hair natural like mine.
If my hair was natural like yours, I would be bald. Oh, sorry. Ooh, Dick. She is bald under there.
Oh, wait a minute. You went bald too.
Bitch. Dear companions, my crony,
my mate,
we'll always be harmonizing. Orphan Annie and Sandy,
my Amos and Andy.
If I say that your sense of style says far off as your youth, it's simply that. Who else but a bosom buddy?
It's time to adjust your age. You try to be Miley Cyrus. You're Lady Macbeth. Exactly how old are you, Marcia? The truth.
How old do you think I am, Lauren?
Somewhere between 40, and you replaced Liza in Best Foot 15 years ago. She just had to go there.
We go back so far, all the way back to Trapper John's days. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that introduction, that was incredible. Thank you. I better not suck. I am so thrilled and honored and excited to be here as your friend tonight, as a performer tonight, as chairman of the board of the Actors Fund as well. Thanks for a really great a shout out to Phyllis, and thank you for it. It's just amazing. I've always wanted to perform in Nothing Like a Dame, and now finally I've seen so many of them. It's great seeing so many trustees in the audience as well, and Joe Bennett and Casa, our president, who's in the back. I also want to give a shout out to Colin, this incredible band. And all of the performers who have donated their time and talents tonight here as well. And for the Dr. Philomena McAndrew Tower Fund Cancer Research Fund. That's a mouthful. Everybody is just doing such great work being here tonight, and I'm just so grateful to be here tonight. I am here tonight. I'm singing for three people: my mother, my mother-in-law. And I just found out about 3 weeks ago that the lady that I call my theater mother, my theater mom, I've known her since she was 14, and she was really the one who kind of gave me my start at San Diego Junior Theater. Just found out that she has breast cancer, and she just started treatments, and Lorna's been so fantastic, you know, just talking to her about that. So this is for all three of those women. Joseph Campbell has a great quote that I love. He says, we must learn to be joyful in the sorrows of life. Mm. Now, that's easier said than done, of course, but I think it's a lot easier done when you got a lot of really great people at your back. And what's really amazing is everybody in this room tonight, because you're here, because of your presence, all the performers, everybody here that bought a ticket, all of the people from the fund and both charities that are here to help. You are those people, and you all have a lot of backs, and you're making it a really wonderful world. So I have a song that I want to do for you.
that helped me put this evening together, both evenings. 6 months ago, I had a dream, if you would like to say, to put on a show and that basically said thank you and expressed my profound gratitude to the people who were not only there for me, but there for all of us who have gone through some devastating times in our lives. And one man stepped up to the plate. He made all of our dreams come true. He doesn't understand the word no, and he doesn't understand the words can't be done. He listens to all of our needs. He is our friend, and he is an angel. Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to make me cry, Joe. The CEO and the president of the Actors Fund, Mr. Joel Benintas. And then none of us could do what we do on this stage without having unbelievable musicians and vocal talent up here with us. And I want you to meet all of them. Ladies and gentlemen, Casey Aaron. Ladies and gentlemen, Gloria Rice. And Mr. Will Palin. Thank you. On drums, Mr. Joshua Priest. Together. He holds us all together. He is not only my arranger, my conductor, but he's the half that makes me whole. Ladies and gentlemen, my husband, Mr. Colin Freeman. Rocky Noel on sound and lights, thank you. Thank you so much. And all of Birdland, Johnny, Valente, I love you. I do. I love you. And I thank every single person who works here at Birdland. I thank you. And I know that she's here tonight. And my friend Kate Edelman Johnson did an amazing job. She really did. You have made my dream come true, and we raised a hell of a lot of money, and I am so, so grateful to all of you. I think we've got a pretty good surprise for you. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, my dear friend and my other sister, Miss Ann Hampton Calloway.
That's a nice family to be a part of. My goodness. You guys really do have designer
dreams,
by the way.
You have to tell Liz that you're part of my family.
That's right. Sharing is caring.
Yes. Well, we have, there have been some pretty epic performances here tonight. Thank you. And it makes me think of another epic performance. And Anne, of course, has been out on the road with an extraordinary show, which is a salute to the incredible Barbra Streisand songbook. And she has been out there doing that. And I have been out there doing songs my mother taught me. So, we thought that we would combine our two shows and maybe take you back when you first saw
these two incredibly brilliant genius performers do this next piece of music. Ready? Here we go!
How about you?
Well, I like a snack or two.
Oh, I like that too.
How about you? I like a fireside when the storm is due. I like potato chips, moonlight, and motor trips. How about you?
I can make up new lyrics, cause that's it.